This video is all about mapping a 16-mile-wide object at a distance of 1,100 light-years. That's more or less like mapping a coin on Pluto from Earth. Yes, I'm talking about a pulsar star, which is a neutron star, the remnant of a once massive star that has collapsed under its own weight and exploded in a supernova fashion. Back in 2019, a team of scientists obtained the first precise measurements of both a pulsar's size and its mass, as well as the first ever map of hotspots on its surface. The studies were performed by two groups, one led by researchers at the University of Amsterdam, and the other led by astronomers at the University of Maryland. Both teams examined X-ray light from the pulsar known as J0030+0451, which lies about 1,100 light-years away in the constellation Pisces. They detected X-rays coming from the pulsar using NASA's Neutron Star Interior Composition Explorer, NICER for short, an instrument aboard the International Space Station, which has been conducting observations since 2017, far away from the obstruction of the Earth's atmosphere. The instrument was built solely for the purpose of learning what happens inside neutron stars, but astronomers will also use it to create an X-ray map of the universe. Pulsars pack more mass than our Sun into a sphere roughly the size of Manhattan. Extreme gravitational forces crush protons and electrons together inside neutron stars, turning them into neutrons. I don't want you to feel dizzy, but these objects can spin up to several hundred times per second, forming intense magnetic fields and beaming radiation into space just like a lighthouse. J0030 revolves 205 times per second. What's interesting about this study, however, is the unexpected location of J0030's hotspots. So far, we have known that these beams of radiation are fired from two hotspots at the magnetic poles, thus resulting in the whole pulsar to glow faintly in X-rays, although the hotspots are brighter. But when scientists observed J0030 using NICER data obtained from July 2017 to December 2018, they found two or three of these hotspots in the southern hemisphere, but there were none in the northern hemisphere. To map these hotspots, scientists used supercomputer models to disentangle where the X-rays originated on the star's surface. While a normal computer would have taken about a decade to complete, the supercomputers did so in less than a month. The University of Amsterdam team identified two hotspots, one small circular spot and one thin crescent-shaped spot, spinning around its lower latitudes. The second team, from the University of Maryland, suggested the same but added that there may be another cooler spot close to the star's south pole. What's more interesting is that the two teams arrived at similar findings independently of one another. These results are definitely not the simple picture astronomers expected, and the pulsar's magnetic field is likely even more complex than originally assumed. However, NICER is doing a great job at helping us figure out what form matter takes in the super-dense cores of neutron stars. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.